It was, good to see the kids as hard as they worked. And I say that weekly, and some of you believe that, some of you don't. But what I can tell you is they work their tails off every time we go to practice. They work their tails off as a group. They really are accountable to each other, and that's important. And that's the way they came out and played. Obviously, we got some good performances from some guys that haven't played as much, but part of that is due because, and I'm talking about Drake probably as much as anybody, he's got a lot of second reps now since Derek went out. So I think when you look at it from that side of it, we've always thought he was talented, and I think he took advantage of an opportunity and did a heck of a job.
Well, sir, Coach, you answered most of my questions regarding. I was going to talk about Johnson and Darboe. Both had 122 and 107 yards, respectfully. Can you talk about Darboe and his receiving today?
Yeah, Mara played a little bit as a freshman, true freshman, and then sat out all last year. And I think the confidence, and again, for both of them, Rodney, being in a system for a first time and learning a little bit of a different system. They both are very talented, we believe. They both work extremely hard. It's nice to see those kind of kids when they get rewarded because of the hard work and what they do. And Amara, when you have Devin on one side and Amara on the other, it maybe opens up some things a little better.
He seemed to tackle well. Was that one of the keys to slowing Tevin Coleman?
Yeah, I mean, the one thing we talked about is keeping the ball inside and in front. And I think the guys up front defensively, you could feel them, the Wormleys, Ryan Glasgow, Monet, Godin. I mean, you could feel those guys. Andre Pipkins, he played probably 8 to 10 snaps, but you can see the line of scrimmage, and that helps our linebackers, and it helps the whole defense when you get that. I got to give credit with how the kids leverage the football, that's the biggest part of it. If you're a cutback guy, be a cutback guy. If you're the force guy, be the force guy. If you're chase contain, you got to chase contain. So. From that standpoint, I think it was really team defense. We had two possessions in there that we really, I know we'll spend a lot of time on tomorrow, but I really think the kids went out there and played on.
Can you talk about the Glasgow play real quick?
Ryan's play?
Yeah.
Ryan is just one of those guys who, it's kind of fun during practice because it's him and his brother every day pounding on each other, and it's the competitive nature of those two. And then tonight, he's a guy who he's going to try and give second and third effort, and to some degree he needs to, because that's what he does best. He's not the quickest guy, probably not the most athletic of the guys in there at the nose, but he always goes over and above when it looks when you talk about the effort that he gives, and it was an effort play.
Brady, at this stage of the season, are you discovering some things about some individual players, learning some things, and also how much of a motivation can getting a bowl bid mean for the team? Are you using
that? Yeah, I'll answer that first. I think that's always something you should think about. I mean, it's nice to get. As coaches, sometimes it's, you get those extra days of preparation and practice and with youth in some ways, that's good. But the other thing is, I think because of injury a little bit, necessity a little bit, you start finding some other guys and just the development of guys in a system. I think that's part of it too.
Mark, in front.
Brady. Little off the game topic, Dave Brandon resigned yesterday. What was your reaction to that?
And I'm not going to talk on that, Mark, because I'm going to talk about what those kids did tonight between the white lines.
And
you know, we got all day Monday, we can discuss that. But this is about these kids going out and beating Indiana.